Hello students, today we are going to do some skill book work of our chapter 2, which is Peshawar. So let's start it. Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Now here we have given a map of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. We have to answer some few questions by looking at the map carefully. Now the first question is, circle these places on the map. B3 Bannu, C6 Chitral, D4 Aptabad. Now in this map we have given a grid with grid square that is black in color and that is F6. There are some numbers given at the top, below the map and at the left and right of the map. So we have to see the numbers carefully, then we have to see the alphabets that are given to us on the top and at the below of the map. And then we have to find these places that are given to us in question 1. And these places are Bannu, Chitral, Aptabad. Then we have to circle these places on this map. And now our question 2 is, in which grid squares are these places? Now here we have given some few places and there are 8 places. So first to read the places and then you have to write the alphabet and the number in which grid square these places are. Like in the first one, in the first question you have to circle the places that are in these grid squares, right? Now you have to you have given the places and you have to find their grid squares and write the alphabet and the number. For example, Peshawar, if we see the grid square, the F6, that is black, it starts, so we know that there are number given over here. So I think Peshawar is in 4th C. So you have to write 4th C in front of Peshawar and you have to find the grid squares of other places too. So moving toward our second page, temperature. Now here we have given a temperature graph for Peshawar of 1 week of June. Now what we have to do is we have to write the temperature of each of the day by seeing the graph. Now how can you see the graph? On Monday the temperature was 42. This one is given to us. Now you have to see Monday and then you have to see the numbers that are given on the left hand side. So where Monday's graph and you have a number and that number is 42 where the Monday's graph end. So means Monday the temperature was 42. Now you have to write the temperature that was on Sunday. So you have to see the graph of Sunday and then you have to see the number. So Sunday the temperature was 39. Now you have to find the temperature of other days by yourself. Now there is a temperature on there's a question, which question number 7, in which they are asking which day had the highest temperature. Now you have to compare all of the days and you have to see the one that graph is the highest. So I think Thursday have the highest temperature. Now you have to write the name of the day that has the highest temperature. Question number 8 is, on which day was it 42? Now you can easily write it because you have already noted the temperature of each of the day. Question number 9 is the same. Now question number 10 is, which day had the lowest temperature? As you have recorded the highest temperature, I have told you how can you record the How can you write the highest temperature? Now you have to write the lowest temperature by yourself. At the bazaar. Now there's another topic. Now here what you have to do is, you have given a picture and this picture is of Rashid's market stall in Peshawar and he sells fruit, but this picture is incompleted. So the thing that you have to do is you have to complete the picture by drawing yourself in the bazaar selling something. And then you have to decide what you are going to sell, and then you have to complete the picture of the bazaar in which you are sitting and selling something. Okay. Now here we have given some few questions and we have to answer them. Question number one is, draw your stall next to Rashid's. Draw all the things you are going to sell. Okay. As I told you that you have to draw a stall of yourself. And then you have to draw the things that you are going to sell. Like you can see the things that Rashid is selling. Rashid is selling fruits, right? So you can see the fruits in the picture. So you have to draw the things that you are going to sell. And the second question is, why did you chose these things to sell? Then you have to give a reason why you think about those things, why you think that you should sell these things. Now, for example, if you are, if I wanted to sell something, that will be books. So I'm selling books because people like to read. This can be my reason, but you have to write your reason. Now it's up to you what you have to sell. Question number three is, are the things you are selling for man, woman or children? Okay. Now here you have to write the thing that you are selling are for whom? For man's, for woman's, for children's. Okay, as I'm selling the books, so they are for all. As all the people, whether they are women or men or children, read books. So they are for all. But you have to write your reason. Now question number four is, what will you do to make people want to come to your stall? Now, as you guys may have visited to a market and you may have seen that many stores in the market use the discount, use a 50% discount or 60% discount to catch the attention of the customers. So I think I will put 50% discount to people want to come to my stall. Now question number five is, how much will you sell your things for? Okay. Now you have to write the price for which you want to sell your things. So I think books are a bit expensive. So I will sell my books for rupees 500. Now you have to choose your price and you have to give your reasons. You can't write about books. Values. Now here we have given a paragraph about forest and forestry. So I'm going to read that paragraph, and then after that paragraph we have given some advantages, some good things about cutting the trees and some bettering things about cutting the trees. And then we have given some questions and you have to answer these questions by yourself by reading the paragraph that is given to us. So first I'm going to read the paragraph and then I'll explain it to you. Forestry, cutting down trees to use the forest, to use the wood. Okay, forestry means to cut down the trees to use the woods. As you guys know that wood is used in many things, in the furniture we have at our homes, at our schools, and it can be used for making pencils, paper. So trees are important for us, wood are important for us. So forestry means cutting down the trees. We cut down the trees for many purposes, for making furniture, for making pencils, for making paper. So forestry is important in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and other parts of Pakistan. Now they are telling that it is forestry means cutting down of trees is important in Khyber and in other parts of Pakistan. In many countries, including Pakistan, the government is trying to find ways to stop too many countries being cut down. They want to make sure that new trees are planted to grow in the place of the ones cut down. Now, some of the regions have many trees, and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa is one of them. So forestry means cutting down of trees is important there because it is a jungle kind of area. So in many countries and including in Pakistan, the government are trying to find a way to stop too many trees being cut down, as there are so many the methods that are being used to cut down trees are not good because they are cutting down so many trees. And trees are important for us as they provide us oxygen and carbon dioxide. So means this is important for us and we should grow trees. We should plant new trees in the place of the ones that are being cut down, because trees are important for us. We get fruit from them. We get fruits from them. We get food from them. We get so many things from them. So it is important to plant new trees in return of the ones that are being cut down. Now here are some good things and are some bad things about cutting down the trees. The good things are people can make money from doing this. We need wood to make things such as paper and furniture. Like I told you that if we cut down the trees, we can make money. Why? Because we can sell the wood that we get from the tree. Yes, the wood is very important. As I told you that it is important because it is used to make paper, furniture and pencils. So we can get money from cutting down, doing this, and we can go get wood. These are two plus points about cutting the trees. But the bad things are cutting down too many trees means animals in the forest have nowhere to live. Cutting down too many trees can make the soil very poor. Okay, as you know that there are many animals that live in the forest, so trees are their habitat. Many of the birds, many of the animals live on the trees, for example monkeys, for example many other birds. So they are their habitat, they are their homes. So if we cut down the trees, where should the animals go? They will die, right? Because trees are their food, trees are their homes, they live there. So cutting down too many trees means animals in the forest have nowhere to live. And then cutting down trees means to making the soil very poor. As you know that water, as you know that tree absorbs the water. So if the soil won't get water, then it will be very poor, very unfertile. So these are two bad things about cutting down the trees. Now you have to think about it and you have to answer the questions that are given at this page. Now I'm going to read the questions. I'll explain you the questions and then you have to answer them by yourself. Question number one. Do you think we should make sure not too many trees are cut down? Say why. Now they are asking the reason that why should we not cut too many trees? I think the reason is because if we cut down so many things, there will be no oxygen. Then if we cut down so many trees, then how can we get wood? How can we make furniture? And if we cut down too many trees, then the trees are the home or the habitat of the animals. So where the animals will go? So, and if we cut down the trees, the soil will become poor. So there are so many reasons. You can write, you can pick one and write it over here. Question number two is, do you think our forests should be logged after so many animals can live there safely? Say why. Now they are asking us that we have to give a reason why our forests should be looked after so animals can live there safely. Now as we cut down the trees, where the animals go? They might die. They die, right? So we have to be careful. We have to look after the animals after cutting the trees, or we should plant more trees. So I think yes, because if the trees are cut down, then there will be no rain. Then we will have droughts, means there will be no rains and the soil will become poor. As the trees observes the water, I told you, as you guys have studied the water cycle in science. So oxygen, if the soils become poor, if we do not get water, if we do not get rain, then how can we survive? Then how can the animals survive? Trees are their food and trees are their home.